Smell is the big one. When I smell a house fire, then that's kind of that kind of triggers me back to being at ground zero.
Tim Link got a phone call at 10 in the morning on September 11th, 2001. He would be deployed for 10 days with 62 people from the Washington Urban Search and Rescue Task Force.
As we're, coming through New Jersey, coming into New York, you can actually see that whole area just glowing. You can see the smoke. And I think that's really where reality set in as far as we've got a lot of work ahead of us.
Link was in charge of the communication system for our search and rescue team. He recalls seeing Ground Zero for the first time. It was 16 acres wide, and the rubble pile was 5 stories high and 8 stories deep.
Well, you remember pretty much all of it. It isn't like you forget something like that.
Today, we know more than 3,000 people died. But at that time, the crew only knew the task of recovery would be monumental.
Where do you start? I mean, you look at Ground Zero, it's just this huge pile. And, NYPD and FDNY, they already had their folks in there. They're already running 2 or 3 days into it with their heavy emotions of losing family and friends and colleagues.
Link remembers walking 2 stories down a makeshift ladder to get onto the pile.
The steel beams, that's different because they're big, you can walk on them. But just the magnitude of the rebar that was around and, you falling, you could wind up being impaled by some of that rebar. I mean, that was a huge safety issue.
Every time a first responder victim was found, a short ceremony was held to honor them as they were extracted from the wreckage. Link says it was hard to watch, but one thing kept him going.
Recovery is just as important as rescue is. I mean, you're putting closures to families.
While working Ground Zero one night, the emotions of being a first responder and a citizen really hit home.
The dust was coming up, the light was hitting in, it just kind of broke that light out. And when I saw that, emotionally I just kind of broke down on that one.
But today it's not as hard as it used to be to bring back those memories.
Not everybody gets the privilege of serving their country to go down to a major event like this that occurs in your nation and be able to do something to help out.
Link says the flight home was quiet. People were digesting what they had just seen.
You just don't know what's going to happen the next day if you're going to be there or not. It taught me to cherish more of what I have.
Megan Hutton, Pierce County News.